Well, good afternoon, guys. I came across a problem. One of my YouTube buddies, 404 man, mentioned about my exhaust and my transmission. So I'm gonna point that out real quick. It's probably gonna be pretty hard for me to change my transmission filter because you see how my exhaust goes right under my pan. I didn't catch that when he was putting my exhaust on, but more than likely, I'm gonna have to unbolt that from the manifold in order to change my transmission filter. That's more than likely what I'm gonna have to do. I hope that fixes the problem. I have to cut my exhaust entirely off because that's a lot of work, but more than likely that's what I'm gonna have to do. Let me look up under here a little bit closer. Yep. I hope I don't have to cut it. But everything's 3-inch now. Yeah, just address that problem to y'all. I think my truck's locked, so. Oh, goodness. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this truck next. I need a paint job. That's really what I need. I just need to get the whole thing repainted either white or gray. And I need to strip this black paint off of these rims because they look better silver. I don't know why the hell I did that, but I did. I need to strip all this white paint off of these bumpers too, turn them back black. Because I really don't like this anymore. They wear this color right here. Right here. Yep. So, future videos to come, I might be doing all that bullshit. But update on my friend's truck. Well, he's like a brother to me. We got his transmission out. We took it down there to this guy, and he's gonna be working on it. Don't know when he's gonna be done. But I put the 22s. We put the 22s back on his truck. They're bent, and I think he's gonna sell it. And whoever buys the truck, that'll be their problem. It's kind of shitty, but really, the rims wasn't my problem. Here's the old shit that came off my truck. 2.5 inch. I need to get the sensors out and put them back in my 3-inch. Just to have them there. I don't need to be going without sensors. Because all it takes is the cops to look under there and see all that bullshit, and then I get a huge ass fine, which I don't need. So yeah, when I get some more money, I'm gonna go down there and take it back to Ridicil. Another problem just came across my mind. I'm gonna show y'all this problem, as a matter of fact, if I can find the keys my dad's chugging to start. I think it's these cats right here, the secondary cats on my dad's truck. I think they're clogged. I hope it's not the first ones because they're right up there by the manifold, and I can't do crap about that because I can't cut them off. But the secondary cats is fine, cut them off. I'm gonna go try and take the trash off in this truck. Find the keys.
First class alibi. This story checks. He's with Kennedy's and Cruz. In fact, we're all running in circles. responsible has probably crossed three time zones by now.
Oh, what time is the freaking... I think they close at 5 or 6. Shit. I hope it's 6. So I'm ready to dump this trash. I'll show you what this truck is doing. I don't have to do that battery crap because the cables are messed up. This truck does not want to go. Okay, the start was no problem. Alright, I'm gonna let him go first. Turn on the air. This truck. It's freaked. I'm just gonna say that it's messed up. When my buddy gets here, I'm gonna see if I can go to his grandpa's shop and get under there with a Metabo blade and go ahead and cut him off a secondary catch to see what that does. But yeah, this truck is not running good at all. I don't even think I can get over 30. Here we go. Hear that? It's not running good at all. I'm gonna try to make it to the trash dumps if they're not closed. It's cutting out already and shaking. Oh yeah. And not 5. If they close at 5, then or if they even opened at all, I'm just slowly going. I mean, I got as little startle as possible. If I give it more, it's just gonna cut out and quit. I'm going literally 15 miles an hour almost, as fast as it'll go. Up, I reached 15. I'm going over 15. I reached 20. I'm not gonna give it any more gas though. I'm just gonna roll. It's downhill too. That's why we're rolling so fast now. But if I try to give it any gas, it's just gonna cut out. I mean, my dad hasn't drove this truck in a while. Sucker's not wanting to do nothing. I just pray that nobody gets behind me. Let me cut the air conditioner down so you can actually hear it. That's crazy. It cut out. Stuck here. Alright, I'm gonna cut this way because that way is uphill. Turn this way. The part I'm worried about is coming back. Come on, don't die, don't die, don't die. It's fixing to die. Okay. Let off of it for a little bit. Okay. Okay, guys, I gotta turn the ignition on. I'm starting to sweat. This is quite, I'm not even gonna say that. Yeah, I am. It's embarrassing as heck because I'm in front of people and this truck is, oh God. Yeah, I'm gonna have to see if I can get a blade and cut these cats off. Don't know if I'm gonna make it back home in this truck. I don't even know if it's gonna make it up this hill. Yeah, it'll make it. I should have took the dirt road from behind my house. It's just been a straight shot. I wouldn't have to go through town. I hope this trash deal is open. And it is, thank the Lord. I can dump this nasty trash off. I see there's no power. I reached 20 miles an hour though. And this truck was really fast when we first got it. It's like, it's faster than my truck, but now there's nothing here. It's like nothing. It's like everything's gone. I better go the other way. This one's full. All right, guys, I'm gonna catch you later because I gotta dump all this trash and there's like tons of it back there as you can see. So, subscribe for content, drop a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Keep it real, and always remember, Jesus loves you.